breathing in the dark, lying on its side. The ruins of the day, painted with a scar. And the more I straighten out, the less it wants to try. The feelings start to rot, one wink at a time. Forgiving who you are, for what you stand to gain. Just know that if you hide, it doesn't go away. When you get out of bed, dawning up stranded, horrified, with each stone on the stage, my little dark age. Through the cards, knowing what's nearby. The carvings on the face say they find it hard. And the engines failed again, all limits of disguise. The humor is not the same, coming from denial. I grieve in stereo, the stereo sounds strange. I know that if you hide, it doesn't go away. If you get out of bed and find me standing all alone, open eyes, burn a page, my little dark age.
We are loud. We are proud. And where are the drugs going? That looks like a cop. Anyway, welcome back, everybody, to the Black Mesa Chronicles. Let's not waste time and get right into it. But before I do, I must explain where I was during this weekend. This whole week, I mean. I kind of had what you could call a sleeping week. Like, I was needing some rest, so instead of, like, streaming, I decided to just catch some Z's. I'm pretty sure that everybody can relate to that feeling of being, you know, sleepy, seeing the bag grow under your eyes, and you just need a break, you know? But hey, I brought something new here, so let's not waste any time and get right into it. Point of view. Okay, let me just test something real quick. See if it bring it leads into something different. Okay, it really is a training room. Fucking Zem. It didn't take much for us to basically go to Zen. We're starting the fucking thing. Zod's journal. Point of view features a journal element that catalogs your character Zon. I'm gonna call him Zon. I'm gonna call it like Zon Ticks. Zon's thoughts throughout his journey. This is so those who can simply play along, but again, I had to start the scrolling text. For your story. Okay. 40 entries. This counting the first one. Remember, it's all a matter of perspective. You know, this is basically that mode in the Half-Life PlayStation 2 version where you can play as Vorgons. I wonder which one came first. But yeah, as you can see, we can do everything a Vorgon can do, which is basically just claw and shoot lightning out of our fucking hands. Well, that was informative. Let's get started. Okay, Sin said, I have a hard time imagining the type of person which would actually put the time and effort to create all these mods which are longer than the game itself. I wouldn't say this is longer than the game itself. I mean, at most, I think that the longest one we played yet was Residual Point, which was the longest. And besides, like I said, it was really, it really led to a pacing issue, you know? I really did not have a good time with that one, especially since it just kept going and going and going. But yeah, I feel like there's some sort of like an art and you balancing it, the length of the mod itself, you know? Because nothing should be as long as the game itself, you know? But remember, guys, it's all a matter of perspective. Before anything, let me just lock something in the controls real quick. Lock strafe ahead, primary attack. This show story, okay, keep it. We are Zun. Man, 2003, this mod is rare. No, not rare, like it ancient. Like this mod is 20 years old this year. Think about that. That's older than most Fortnite's fan base. Low hanging fruit, I guess, but I don't apologize for anything. It's going to be a very text-heavy mod, so keep that in mind. I'm going to try to keep voice a little bit more like they were like in Half-Life 2, so I am the one Noah Suck, child, citizen, follow of the great Nihilith. An outward appearance, I seem to be a mere worker, but self-deceptions is part of my design. Though the blessing of my father, my leader, and my master, I was chosen amongst the gifted, a super worker. I am smarter, stronger, and faster than most of my kind. I exist as I do because of the great invasion. As it dawned, the great Nihilith turned to the ancient prophecies and found a passage indicating the invaders' own strength could be used against them. The inhabitants of the border wall, these so-called humans, had broken the natural order by adapting the environment to their needs instead of evolving. They achieved this unnatural effect through technology. While the Overseer caste is traditionally the most intelligent one, technology is so radically different from our old evolutionary path that no existing Zenizen was capable of grasping it. The great Nihilith toured the birthing incubators and channeled his wisdom, his will, and his power into the creation of a new subcaste of extraordinarily gifted citizens. It is in our very nature to be malleable. Oh. We have a red vision. Awesome. Hey, my bros, how are you doing? You're doing great, sir. Smack. What? You're gonna attack me? You're gonna piss off the superiors? They remind you who is God here. The Nihilith is God. Work faster, deep shit. But yeah, it's technically not the first time we have seen something like this. Because Gearbox has made a mode in Half-Life from the PlayStation 2 where you control the a pair of Oregons. It's really cool, actually. Is everything going around here well? You know, I just noticed from here. Controllers? Tiny ass. Organs? No ass. Hate this. Why did they make the elevator spin? That's so dumb. It's basically a puke machine. A puke machine, I tell you. What the fuck was that? A dead controller? Who could have done this? Orange-clad monsters from another dimension.
What is it? I've got to get out of here. Get out! Get the door!
After them! Okay, introductions are Creature Associates. Okay, look, I'm gonna be honest here. I am not gonna read all this. Like, includes like a lot of lore, headcanon lore here. It's really awesome and all, but I am gonna waste so much precious time just reading all this. So if you guys want to read it, I'm pretty sure it's very interesting. I have read some of it before, when I was like playtesting this. It's really good. It's just, you know, it just takes a little too much time. No. The humans have somehow infiltrated the facility and they stolen the XBTS. I must retrieve it or it's my life is forfeit. See what happened to the workers who failed to stop the humans, struck down by the overseers. They were lucky death embraced them as quickly as it did. If the XBTS, the sole reason I exist, fall into the hands of the enemy, I have more to fear than death. Once informed, the Great Nihilus will reach out with his mind and quill me. Yeah, basically, Zahn is kind of screwed. We gotta stop this human. We gotta get the MacGuffin back. The MacGuffin is mine, bitch. Shoot them fools! I really wish there was like an aim thing there, you know? Reckless pursuit. Oh dear, alright. Go back here. Prodigy. So basically what this one is saying is that the way that we recover health in this point is by confronting humans. See? So we gotta actually go for a somewhat aggressive playstyle. Yeah, battlefields in. Yeah, for instance, scuba stukabats. Oh, the spearmen, mantras, kind of great. Those are chemicals. Okay, so they kind of act like the yeah, they kind of act like the snarks. Snarkios. Oh. Oh, Gargantuan, help me! I can't believe I'm glad to see you. Yeah! Woohoo! Get him, Gargantuan! Oh. Oh, sure. Now that I want you to stay here, you don't. Asshole. Headshot. Yeah, get used to the charging noise of the Gorgons. We're gonna be hearing it a lot of it. Ooh. Oh, hi. Great job, my brethren. We'll show them what's good for. Yeah. Gorgons rule, motherfucker. Puny humans. Young fool, only now, at the end, do you understand the power of the Zen side. Oh. Zen, healing pools. So this kind of gives an explanation of the healing pools. Apparently it's like microorganisms that eat the dead tissue while creating not that tissue. It's really cool, but again, we can't read all of it.
I don't wanna die.
Maybe you shouldn't have invaded my home planet, you puny humans, motherfuckers. Go back to work. We're in the middle of a crisis. Who told you you can just stay there and not... Who said you could just stay here and not work? Okay, where are we? Stand no chance against our might. We are under alien invasion, and I will not accept any lollygagging. I gotta get back that MacGuffin, or I'm screwed. Seems like I can't get his help from destroying non-biological life. Deep telepathic inhalation. Yes. Like we're fucking sniffing it out. I don't think Vargas even like knows this. Yep. So yeah, I can't use these things. But yeah, they also obviously added like different weapons for you to use, but they added different weapons for you to use, but still. Sorry, verse of habit. I know there's nothing here I could use, but still. I am very familiar with human trickery. I swear, if there are fucking hand crabs here, I'm gonna be very upset. Man, these things are weak. Why do they have like these things on the wall? Guys, do you recognize that? It's the blue HEV suit. It's the Barney suit from Azuri Sheep. Guys, we have a connection. We have an actual connection. Isn't this awesome? Oh man. So these suits, man, like way too, like it's all coming together, like full circle. Oh yeah, it's all coming together. But yeah, it's the blue suits from Azuri Sheep. What does it all mean? What does it all mean? Maybe I should not shoot these barrels. Or these blocks. Back here, human. They have these armors, but at the same time, their defenses can't stand them out of my claw. These blue symbiotes. That's a large number, they need to get like this. Primary defense purposes. Wait. The warrior workers can be distinguished from regular workers from their magenta skin tone and improved fire rate. The coloration change comes from mixing a little of Junto generic material? My my mind is getting blown because now it's all coming together with the Zuri Sheep. But those experiments the G-Man was making, it's all being recontextualized in my head. Like, I'm gonna tell you how I'm feeling right now. Except it does make sense. Oh my god. So this is what the G-Man was creating? Doing a Zui Sheep? He was creating a warrior? Warriors? From you mixing DNA of Chumtoad with humans? Or maybe the warriors that we're seeing, that we'll see here in Zen, are different from the ones that we're seeing as Zui Sheep. I don't know, man. I don't know. I legit don't know. Oh my god, I'm going crazy here. Come back here. Little prick. Just look at them. Nothing this week is meant to survive. Where is the MacGuffin? Surprised to see me? I'm not like the others. I'm actually dangerous. No, well, unauthorized personnel. This can't stop me. I don't know English. See, it's the female security guards from Azuri Sheep. Like, oh my god. G-Man, it's those guys. They use the pulse rifles. It's them. Dark designs, teleportation abilities. Dark humans. So clearly this is still okay. Are these the Black Ops, or these are just G-Man's exclusive soldiers? Oh man. Okay, let me just Yeah, there we go. Much better. These creatures are fascinating. They need to be studied by force. I suggest we show them our peaceful ways by force. We can see them using the pulse rifles.
My God, what are you doing?
Seems like they are exactly very loyal to their own kind. Opposing forces. Yep, the MacGuffin was taken. Let me just... Zen Techno Biology Sphere, that's what the MacGuffin is. Oh yeah, MacGuffin. I really need to find the MacGuffin. Or else my ass is grass. Chum toads. Hey, boys. Oh, chumps. Exploding self-defense. Isn't that a little bit, redundant? Not really, like, redundant. It's like, self-defeating. So yeah, picking some female frogs here. I'm glad that they give us like different weapons, but you know, I think that the frequency that they give us is so, you know, infrequent that I don't know. I don't know if we're gonna have too much use for these things. I could be wrong though. Bastards. Ouch. Damn it. Those motherfuckers. The noggin. They're so adorable in a ugly alien toad way. But hey, I could have some fun with this. John Toad, I choose you. Oh. Town toads are useless. Good to know. This is why you just stick on using the classic. Yep, it's the same guns from Azuri Sheep. The pulse rifle, even a weird like revolver Beretta looking thing. It all comes together. Hey, give that back. There we go. Go back, give it back. Oh, those assholes. They're tire trucks. Wheels. Step into my parlor. Come back here. Hairless apes. Oh shit. Fuck. taste the chum toad. Motherfuckers. That's why they had a healing pool there. Because you have like no aiming dot here. I don't know what it's gonna hit. I love these sort of, you know, cheap sections that they add in moments like these in games. Okay, so hey, this will work. Good. One. There we go. So now they have this healing pool, so you can recover from that shit. This is when you take a sip of your water. Hopefully this noise does not make you want to pee. Oh shit. Oh, violence always is the answer. Malice in Wonderland. Again, if you wanna again, if you want to read like the whole of it, so if you want to read like the whole thing, you can, but you know, for sure you can. Where is the MacGuffin? Headshot. Hmm. these things tend to explode. My brethren, hellbound. Recapturing, studying others. We're gonna teach him a lesson. Steady. Steady. I mean, how much the G-Man is paying you guys? I mean, I'm not exactly a follower to a possibly dark entity, but you know. I'll change. Gray suits. Have we ever seen gray suits? Are they associated with these or? Oh man. I have to stop trying to piece this whole thing together. But I can because I'm clinically insane. Where is the security card? I mean, does Zahn even know what security card even is? I mean, they don't seem to be the biggest fan of technology and stuff, so I would assume that they don't know. Oh well. Oh, my brethren, they're free! March forward. So, are you guys gonna follow me or? Nope, it seems like this is not a mechanic. Oh, so sadly. We're able to get some level payback, am I right, boys? But yeah, in terms of weapons, it seems like you're mostly gonna stick with the lightning bolt and desperately it. But I'm really enjoying what it's doing. Like this direction, I'm really digging it. They really make it clear it's all a matter of perspective. Some healing pool here for my troubles. There we go. So, what's inside this? Oh, just a hole to eternity. Okay. Man, they have freaking Magnum. You really fucked up there. I can't stop. Especially now, because you're dead. I'm sorry, did I break your concentration? Ah, God, what a maze. One by one. So we were like worms or a hive mind of sort. Like we are still a hive mind, but single reproductive female. Man, could they be implying that the Nylanth is what caused them to evolve into this point? Maybe? God, I have no idea. This is just sums up this whole thing up. I have no idea. I have no flying idea. There's no earthly way of knowing of where we are rolling. Yes, I am. I'm so serious that you're dead. Nice medical station. Fell out of good, did you? This mod. It allows me finally to kill the scientist without any sort of guilt. Leave no survivors. None of them deserve to live. They don't look like us, they don't talk like us. Therefore, they must die. Is this place? What, no little entry on your mind there, Zon? No comment on how humans relieve themselves of their waste? Like a maze here. Rat race. Yep, pretty much just saying that, it's fucked. It's a very confusing layout. Give what? Yeah, whatever. Pretty sure it was nothing important. Interesting HEV suits. Would be a real shame if, autistic idiot like me would go crazy over it. Caution. I'm of Oregon. I don't have any fears for your radiation. Wouldn't it be funny if I caused like a freaking nuclear explosion in Zen? Which, I don't know, maybe at the end of Visitors, that might have happened? I mean, you guys remember that shit? Damn it. Okay, rat race. Look, it's their arsenal. A lot of good is doing against me. You say something? No? I'm pretty sure it was nothing important. Man, rivers of radioactive waste. What would make a facility with these obvious safe hazards? Jeez. Don't these humans care about their fellow brethren? It's a revolver, huh? Nice. Thanks for just standing there and taking it. There has to be a way of releasing these grunts. They could be useful. Thank you. Sector D. Thanks for the health, dummies. Cause that's what you are, you're a bunch of fucking dummies. Exactly what I needed. Guess I'm not going here. Guess I'm taking the long way. How can Vorgons even like use human stairs? Elevator reach all the way up there? Well, I guess so, but it takes a freaking eternity. It's just best in that case, just let gravity do the work. Cufflinks. I feel we're like close to the end already. Fools. Thank you. Your karate ain't gonna help you. Asshole! That motherfucker. Welcome to Earth. Where am I? Actually, before anything, let me just check what's here real quick. Sewage. Wonderful. Welcome to Earth. Surprise. Gravity is heavier. I mean, the border world. They think the Earth is the border world? I see. Nice try. Another one. They're in for a very surprise to see a piece of Zen. Let's follow them home. Thank you. Find my way around, find my way around. Looking round about. Looking around, looking around. Shut the fuck up. Looking around, looking around. Looking around, looking around. Shkabadi boo, boobity ba. Ba ba da boo. Scappity boo, scappity boo. Shabaraba, doobity doo. Bright eyes. Five different eyes. So I can't do any attack here.
It can't get any worse than this.
It can. It always can. Man, I don't remember you. You appear on a Zuri sheep. Or a guy. It always can. I mean, you could have, you almost been giving a chance to just get away with everything. You just didn't have to like come after me. But hey, he's a scientist. That doesn't mean that he's smart.
Oh no.
Why not? Might as well keep you, let you go. Yeah, run off. Can't be reasonable. mean, you need to run out of ammo eventually. You're trying to use my own tricks against me, Potter? A fucking crowbar? Not a wise move, asshole. I've been using crowbars even before you knew how to crawl. Oh, a piece of... He's a bar of steel. What the fuck would use that a bar of steel, huh? Now we're gonna be doing like a sound effects when you use them. Oh, a knife. Fine, fuck off.
No, I don't want to die!
Actually, can you run into those laser trip mines? I would appreciate it.
Oh, no.
No, go there. Go there! Stop doing the scare dance. This only ends one way, bro.
No.
Yes. God damn it, go back there. He just needed a little incentive.
Oh,
just doing the Resonance Cascade? I mean, I can see it being either way. Oh no. Oh, there's my answer. Excellent job. I wonder if I can, like, get him to follow me somehow. I'll take that as a no. Excellent. Okay, who is that guy? Interesting, I recognize him. He will need someone to shepherd him out of here. Completely immune to the barnacles. That's the way I like it, and I'll never get bored. So close. There's a freaking mine in Black Mesa. Do I need to start listing the issues with that? Man, will we actually be able to finish this? I do wonder. Stupid rats.
I just want to get out of this alive.
Where if we don't have a mine sequence, I'm going to be very upset. Man, those are some tough-ass boards. Well, the rats have become a little bit, carnivorous in this sector. Again, I wonder what's the logic behind this place. Clearly, as we saw, Adrian freaking Shepherd. That puts us during the events of opposing forces. Or at least,
I hope you know what you're doing.
At least in the beginning of opposing forces, because Adrian Shepherd was out for a while, maybe, so I got captured. Fuck. Let me out here, you Einstein motherfucker. You're a nerd.
End of the line for you.
End of the line for me, huh? How about you remove this stupid glass between us and, you know, we'll see about that. Get me out of here. Thanks. Guys, isn't this place familiar? This is another location from Missouri Sheep. Free at last. I don't feel the need for approval as strongly as before. Could our lead be going on a quest? Oh. Look at this little bugger. I hate them even when they are on my side. Snarks. Am I right? Was this like after the events of Azuri Sheep? After we've been here? It seems very likely that that's what happened. Seems like Varney has already been here. Cages. The hive hand. I never acquired this hive hand in a Azuri Sheep. But now I do. Ooh, it all comes together. Seriously, that's a great attention to detail. Oh, there you are, my big friend. You want to get out, don't you? Girl power. Nylumph is a misogynist. Would have funk it. Motherfuckers. Ah, one of these, the snarks. Exactly what I needed. It's like girl power, it wasn't enough. There you are, Chum Toads. How are you doing? Oh, a Golnark. Even with this thing on my side, I still hate its fair sight. She's delighted in death. Oh, the security card. You don't say. Right on the eye. You only had one shot. And you blew it. Holy shit. A minigun? I remember that from a zoo shape. There you are, my large brethren. You shall taste freedom. Thank you. Anyway, as to how I'm going to free him, I'm gonna leave this for next episode. So yeah, this is being Point of View, everybody, and I am legit having a good time. I'm still recovering a little bit from exhaustion that I had to take kind of like a short break to recover from. This way I did not have like as much commentary as I would like to have had. So anyway, really hope you enjoyed it anyway. Thanks so much for watching my videos and streams. I appreciate each one of you. Check out the place, the server where you're always welcome. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Hank out.